In this video, we're going to learn how we can create this animated button, which is a circular button where we have this circular pulsing effect. If you like this kind of videos, please let me know by liking and subscribing to the channel. And also a big shout out to Shannon Galloway, which is the official sponsor of this video. He's supporting me on Patreon, which you can find down in the description. And let's get started. So looking at the code here, we have a simple starting project. So I'm gonna start off by just removing all of the comments so we can have that basic page. Now I'm also going to pretty much just remove this home page. And inside this here, we are just going to write home page. So let's create that by just going to the lib folder and creating another folder called home. And then just creating the homepage.dart. We're just going to create this as a stateless widget, which is going to be a scaffold. That's all for now. So let's take this homepage and importing it at the main file. So now when we have started the application, we can see that the application is just white, and that's because we just have the scaffold. So to start with this, we're going to pretty much just change the background color of the scaffold. So if we go to the main file and we go to theme data, we can set the scaffold background color to something like blue-gray, just so we get another kind of effect or another color. So now to actually implement the design, let's go to the home page. We can now close down the main file. And inside this scaffold, we're simply going to have a body with a center. And inside this center, we're going to show our widget. So let's create something like pulsating circle icon button. So let's create that widget. And this widget, what we're actually going to do is that we're going to have a stateful widget. And the reason for this is because we're going to make an explicit animated widget. So with implicit, we actually don't have to use any kind of controllers, but with explicit, we have to provide our own controller. So what we're going to do is that we're going to define the different controllers for the animation. So what we're going to do first is pretty much just create the basic outline of how the widget will look like. So instead of a container, we will have an inkwell because we want this button to be clickable. Inside this inkwell, we can set a border radius. We set it to a circular 100, and this will just make it a complete circle. For the on tap, we will just ignore for now. We can close this. And for this child, we're going to have a ink. So I will just explain why we're going to have an ink, but let's just add it for now. So the ink is going to have the defining of the padding. Let's set it to something like 16. For the child, we're going to have some kind of icon. Let's do it like that. And let's take the same color as the scaffold. So what we're also going to do is actually add some decoration to this ink. So let's do that before the child. And we're going to pretty much define three different things. So we first have to define the color, then we have to define the shape and also the shadows, or not the shadows, or the actual circles. So for the color, we'll set it to something like white for now. The shape, which is just going to be box shape circle. And then for the shadows, which is going to be an array, because we, with box shadow, it actually requires us to have a list of box shadows. So what we're going to have is actual two shadows. And those are going to be different radius. So we're going to use a for loop for that. And we're going to start with one for that one, and I will explain why. So now let's create the box shadow, which is going to define two things. So first one is color, and let's just take something like colors.white with opacity of 0.5 for now. And then for the spread, for now we can take something like I times 20. This is going to be changed with the animation. We're just going to format that. So now we're just going to use that. And I can see that I misspelled it. So now if we actually show the application, we can see that we have this kind of application. So what we have here in the middle is the actual button. Then we have the circle or the first box shadow. And then we have the second box shadow. So here we can see why we are doing the opacity. So the first one here is actually the one you will see below. So it will have a opacity of 50%. Then we have another one which is larger out, but that part where it covers this one will be adding to that white color. So that's why it will have a stronger white color. So now to add the animation to this. So what we want to do is somehow change this color depending on the animation. And we also want to change the spread radius. So let's start. And when we want to have a animation, we have to define that we are going to have an animation. So that requires us for a single ticker provider state mixing. So if you would use multiple animations, you would have a ticker provider state mixing. But as we're just using one, we're going to have a single one. We're going to define our controller and also our animation. Actually, we're just going to start with the animation controller, and I will show you why we could create the animation after that. So for the init state, we have to actually instantiate that animation controller. So inside this, we are going to set the vsync. And that will reference its the actual class because it has the single ticker provider state mixing. We are also going to define the duration. And as this will be pulsating, we're going to set it to something like 2 seconds. So now for it to actually animate, we're going to call the animation controller. We can have it to repeat. And this starts this animation going forward and then restarts the animation when it completes. So that's almost what we want. This will actually start the animation and then go forward. And then to the end, it will actually restart the animation completely. And we will see how that looks. So saving that, we are now going to define how we're actually going to rebuild this widget. So every time that this animation changes or this animation controller, we want to somehow update the widget tree. So one way is calling setState each time, but we don't actually want to rebuild everything. We simply just wanted to rebuild pretty much this part right here. We want to rebuild the ink one or the ink widget. So to do that, we are going to wrap this with a widget. Now I prefer wrapping it with stream builder because this just gives us the actual builder method wrapping it. So we're actually just going to change this. So it will be an animated builder. And for the animation, we're going to set it to the animation controller. And then for the snapshot will be the child which we are not actually requiring. So we'll just put an underscore there. So now we can start doing some changes. So for example, the opacity, we can set that to the animation controller value and just divide that with 2, for example. And for the spread radius, we can just take the animation controller.value times I. So that's the reason why we pretty much started the loop at 1. We could also add 1 to this one, but it's easier to start it at 1 and then stop it when we are equal to 2 instead. So that will run two times. So if we just save this and restart, we can see that nothing has really changed. So we can see that something is actually happening in this circle, but it's not what we're actually seeking. So the reason for this is because we're actually dividing and adding depending on the value of this animation. But this animation controller just starts from 0 and goes to 1. So we have to somehow define that this animation controller is going to have a specific start point and a specific end point. So to do that, we define an animation. And this one is going to start as well. And this one we're going to decide here what we want to do. So for example, below this animation controller, let's just make this a one line for now. So before we start the actual animation, we're going to set what this animation is going to be. And we're going to define a tween. So what the tween is we check the documentation. It gives us a way to define a begin and end property for a tween. So with a tween, we can just define a start and end value. So for example, or a begin and end value. So for the begin, let's set it to 0. And then for the end, let's set it to something like 12. And then we can just use this to define a begin and end value. So for the begin value, we're going to set it to 0. And for the end, we're going to set it to something like 12. Now we can call animate. So with this animate, we actually can define which the parent is for this animation. And the parent is actually used the animation controller. And by stopping here and saving, we're not actually complete. So we can see that this animation is not used. That's because we're using the animation controller everywhere. So instead of using an animation controller, which starts from 0 to 1, we're going to use our animation, which starts from 0 and goes to 12. Because this animation controller just controls this animation from going to 0 to 12. So saving this and restarting. So now when we have defined what this animation is going to be, we actually have to use it as well. So the animation controller has a value from 0 to 1, while the animation has a value from 0 to 12. So let's use that. So for the animation control, for the animation, we can just specify the animation. For the opacity, we are not going to use the animation control or the animation object. The reason for that is because we don't want to divide 12 with 2 for the opacity, for that would be 6. And the opacity just takes a value between 0 and 1. So we're going to use the animation controller because if we get to the max value of the animation controller. So if we get to the max value of the animation controller, which would be 1, we can just divide it by 2, and that would be 0.5. But for the spread radius, we're going to use the animation.value, because now we'll have, for example, 2 times I or 5 times I. So if we save this and go to the application, we can see that we have this kind of animation right now, which is not completely what we want, but we're close. So going back to the application, we can now define how this is going to repeat. So as I said before, this actually starts and goes to the end and then restarts, but we can give it a reverse variable and just set it to true. So if we just hover this and look at the documentation, we can see with reverse set to true, instead of always starting over at minimum, we start the value with alternating between the maximum and minimum. So let's save that and just check the application now. We actually have to restart it as well. We can see now that it starts to pulsate. So now we're almost done. We actually just have to do one more thing, and that's defining how we want this curve to be. So right now it's just animating at a consistent pace. So for example, it goes from 0 to 12 to for 2 seconds. With the exact same interpolation, and I'm back with the same time and interpolation. So we want to change how the curve actually is. So where we are defining our animate for the animate controller, we can wrap that in a curved animation. And this requires some things that we will have to define. So I'm just going to do like this so we can actually see. So we are going to have the parent, and this is the same as before, which is the animation controller. But we can also define the curve. And we can also define the reverse curve if we want to, but we're just going to define the curve for everything. And what we're going to use is curves is out. So now if we save this, looking at the application, we can see now that we have this pulsating animation where the animation is not a completely linear animation, but we actually have a curve in it. And now we just have to do one more thing, and that's actually just making this widget reusable. So for example, we have to define a onTap for it. So we're going to define a gestureTap callback, which we just call onTap. And we're going to define also which icon we're going to use. So final icon, icon. Let's create a constructor. And what we're also going to do is require these two. So now let's go back at the bottom. Here we didn't have anything before, so we can just write widget.onTap. And for the icon, we're simply going to change that. So let's just add this one for formatting. And we're going to take or copy all of this code or cut it out. And then here we can just write widget.icon. Now up at the top, we can write the icon which we are going to use, and then also the onTap. And we're not going to do anything special, we just do it like that. So with this, we actually have a reusable widget where we can put whatever we want, where we can define the icon, the onTap, and also we would then have that animation. I hope you like this kind of video. Please let me know by liking and subscribing to the channel. Let me know what you would like to see next. And also be sure, of course, to check out my Patreon. It really helps. And I will see you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.